Good morning students, welcome back to saradamathschannel channel, and this is the continuation video of the trigonometric ratios up to transformations IMP to mass questions. Okay, let us start the problem. The first one, if cos A is equal to cos B is equal to minus 1 by 2 and A doesn't lie in the second quadrant and B doesn't lie in the third quadrant, then find the value of the 4 sin B minus 3 tan A. By 3 tan A by tan B plus sin A. Okay, 4 sin B minus 3 tan A by tan B plus sin A. We have to find this value. These two values are given, cos A value, cos B value. Cos A is equals to minus 1 by 2, cos B is equal to minus 1 by 2. And also given that A doesn't lie in the second quadrant, B doesn't lie in the third quadrant. So first here I am writing the given data. What is the given data? Given that cos A is equal to minus 1 by 2 and cos B is equal to minus 1 by 2. The two values are same here. Okay. Cos A is equal to minus 1 by 2. Cos B is equal to minus 1 by 2. And given that A doesn't lie in the second quadrant. A does not belongs to Q2. A doesn't lie in the second quadrant and B doesn't lie in the third quadrant. Okay. These two conditions are given. Okay, what is given here? Cos value is negative. Cos negative means cos is negative in the second quadrant and third quadrant. A is negative in the second and third quadrants. So here clearly given that A does not belongs to Q means directly you can tell that A belongs to Q3. Since cos is negative in these two quadrants only, already given that this not in the second quadrant, that is that must be lying in the third quadrant. Understand? And here also cos B is equal to minus 1 by 2 means cos is negative in the only second and third quadrants, but clearly given that this note in the third quadrant, that is B belongs to Q2. Okay, this is negative means this lies in the third quadrant, third or second, but given that this note in third quadrant, so that is that must be lie in the second quadrant. So these are the quadrants in which the angle say gamma B lies. So what is the question? We want this value. So first I am taking these four values separately. What we want? We want the values tan A, sin A, tan B and sin B. We have to find all these values. Okay. So first I am taking the right angle triangle here. This is the right angle triangle and here this is the A angle. Okay. What is given here? Cos A is equals to minus 1 by 2. That is adjacent by hypotenuse. Adjacent value 1, hypotenuse value 2. Just leave that sign. That indicates the only quadrant. Okay. Now what is this opposite side value? This is equals to 4 minus 1. 2 square minus 1 square. That is equals to root 3. Okay. Hypotenuse square minus side square. 4 minus 1 is equal to root 3. Now coming to the second one, again taking the right angle triangle for the B angle also, this is the angle B. Here also given the same value is 1, 2. That is adjacent is equals to 1, hypotenuse is equals to 2. So this value is equal to, again the same answer, hypotenuse square minus side square, root 4 minus 1 is equal to root 3. Okay, now finding the values. What we want, sin A value, tan A value. That is sin A is equals to, what is the formula? Opposite by hypotenuse, that is root 3 by 2. Okay, but A is in the third quadrant and in the third quadrant sin is negative, so you have to take the minus sign also. This is opposite by hypotenuse, but in the third quadrant sin is negative, so again you have to take this negative sign, minus here. And what is the second value we want? Tan A. What is the tan A formula? Opposite by adjacent, that is root 3 by 1, but here in the third quadrant tan is not negative, so we don't take the negative sign, this is plus only, that is this value is equal to root 3 only. Okay, now coming to this one, here we want the value sin B tan B. What is sin B? Sin B is equals to opposite by hypotenuse, that is root 3 by 2. Opposite value root 3, hypotenuse value 2. But B lies in the second quadrant. In the second quadrant, tan is sin is positive. That is, we don't take the negative sign. Second quadrant, sin positive. Okay. Answer is equal to only root 3 by 2. Now coming to the last value. The last value is tan B. Tan B is equal to, from this, from the diagram, opposite by hypotenuse, that is root 3 by 1. But here B is in the second quadrant. In the second quadrant, tan is negative, so you have to take the minus sign. These signs are very, very important here to get the answer. Okay, these are the four values. Now substituting the four values in the given question. Okay, what is the question here we have? Therefore, 4 into sin B minus 3 tan A. Okay, 4 into sin B minus 3 tan A by tan B plus sin A. So this is the quotient. Now substituting the values in this quotient. So this is equals to 4 into sin B value is equal to root 3 by 2. Okay. Minus 3 into tan A value is equal to root 3 whole by tan B. Tan B is equal to minus root 3 plus sin A. Sin A is equal to minus root 3 by 2. Now taking the simplification. So this is 4 root 3 minus doing the LCM 2 3 is 6 minus 6 root 3 by 2. Okay. First in the numerator doing the LCM. And next here also doing the LCM minus 2 into root 3 minus 2 root 3 minus root 3 by 2. Now cut the 2 and 2. So this is equals to 4 root 3 minus 6 root 3 is equal to minus 2 root 3. And this is minus 2 root 3 minus root 3 is equal to minus 3 root 3. Cut the sine and root 3. Therefore the answer is equals to 2 by 3. Therefore the value of the 4 sin B minus 3 tan A by tan B plus sin A is equal to answer 2 by 3. That's all. This is the answer. Very easy question, but the important question. Okay. In the first exercise of this topic, all the problems are very important. All are IP 2 marks problems. So all of you prepare all these problems without leaving the questions. Okay. Okay, see the next problem. If alpha comma beta are the complementary angles such that B sin alpha is equals to A, then what is the value of the sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta? So this condition is given here, B sin alpha is equals to A, and given that alpha comma beta are the complementary angles, so what is the meaning of the complementary angles? The sum of the two angles is equal to 90. Alpha plus beta is equal to 90. That is given. And this condition is given, we have to find this value. Okay. So first I am writing the given data here. What is the first condition given here? Given that alpha comma beta are the complementary angles. The meaning of the complementary angles is sum of the two angles is equal to 90 degrees. Supplementary angles means sum of the two angles is equal to 180. And complementary angles means sum of the two angles is equal to 90. Therefore, the value of the alpha plus beta is equal to 90. So, alpha plus beta is equal to 90 means what is the value of the beta? Beta is equal to 90 minus alpha. Okay. Okay, this is the first condition given. And also given that the value of the B sin alpha is equal to A. B sin alpha is equals to A means what is sin alpha? Sin alpha is equals to A by B. Okay. So what is the question? We want the value of the sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta. So only one sin alpha value is given. From this I am finding the cos alpha value. Cos alpha is equals to. Okay. Now for this taking the right angle triangle here. This is the alpha value. So what is given? Sin alpha is equal to A by B. What is sin alpha formula? Opposite by hypotenuse. Okay. Now what is the value of the adjacent side? Now square root of hypotenuse square minus side square. Okay. Square root of B square minus A square. This is the adjacent side value. So what is cos alpha value? Adjacent by hypotenuse. That is square root of B square minus A square by B. Okay. This is the value of the cos alpha. Now finding the answer. Therefore we want the value of the sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta. So this is equals to sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta is equals to. Now substituting the values, before replacing the sin alpha cos alpha value, first I am taking the beta value. What we have? Beta is equal to 90 minus alpha. So this is sin alpha into cos beta is equal to 90 minus alpha. Okay. Minus cos alpha into sin. Here also beta is equal to 90 minus alpha. Okay. And this is equals to sin alpha into cos 90 minus alpha is equal to sin alpha. Cos 90 minus theta formula sin theta. Minus cos alpha into this is sin 90 minus alpha. Sin 90 minus alpha is equal to cos alpha. Okay. Cos 90 minus theta, sin theta. Sin 90 minus theta, cos theta. Now this is sin alpha into sin alpha is equal to sin square alpha minus cos alpha is equal to cos square alpha. What is sin square alpha value? Already here we have that sin alpha is equal to A by B. a by b whole square minus cos alpha value square root of b square minus a square by b whole square. Okay, these two are the values of the sin alpha comma cos alpha, and this is now squaring the terms here, a square by b square minus here square root, square root gets cancelled. So what will be the remaining value? B square minus a square, okay, by b square. So denominator value whole square is equal to b square. Now doing the LCM, a square minus b square minus of minus plus a square by b square. Okay, a square, applying the minus end to these two values, minus b square minus of minus plus a square. So this is equal to a square plus a square is equal to 2a square minus b square. Therefore, the answer of sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta is equals to sin alpha cos beta minus cos alpha sin beta is equals to, answer is equal to 2a square minus b square by b square. That's all. This is the answer. Understand all of you? The most important math question. Okay. I will continue the remaining sums in the next video.